What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in.
It's me,
Mikey Pipes. Tuesday, June 17th, 2025. It is 8 o'clock on the dot. We are at the install we're doing today. I also have a service call scheduled for later this afternoon at around 2 to 4 o'clock. Today, we are gonna be decommissioning this 4-ton Rheem 410A system. Daniel and our new hire, an apprentice, who just graduated HVAC school yesterday, getting his NORA certification and his Universal 608 certification, will be working downstairs in the crawl space, dismantling the existing air handler with hydronic coil, and then putting in the private label Mikey Pipes by ACIQ Extreme Plus ultra efficient DC driven air handling unit. I got my tool bag. Slam that right on top of this jetty. I got my climate class probes, which, by the way, I am very disappointed. Very disappointed in these climate class probes. I'm gonna tell you why, and then I'm gonna get rocking and rolling here. It's pathetic, actually. Let me see, where is it? There it is. You see this temperature clamp? All right, well, there used to be two of them. The other one's broken because this little thing right here snaps in half just by normal use. Brand new set, broke through two of them already. Just better, just garbage if you ask me. But the great folks over at True Tech Tools, where I purchased this $1,000 set from, they're sending another replacement. So I should have some backup inventory because I can't use it for the full capability of having both temperature clamps, but whatever. Let's pump down this system. Let's get rocking and rolling. All right, I got my contactor jammed closed. We're at 72 PSI and dropping. Are you kidding me? You gotta be kidding me. I can't even get it in there. Oh my God. Son of a gun. Negative 10. Frozen up right there. Almost closed. Pump down. Beautiful. Negative 10 on our suction side coming back to the condensing unit. We've just successfully pumped down the refrigerant in our liquid line, suction line, and the evaporator back into the condensing coil. Now, you can't do this every single time. Won't be able to get away with it every single time, but when you can do it, try it, because I just saved myself about 45 minutes of total time setting up a recovery machine, the recovery tank, recovery scale, all that good stuff. I just saved all that time. Now look at it, 7 minutes after 8. Keeping it real. All right, I just pulled the disconnect plug from our disconnect going to this condensing unit. Let's check for voltage at our contactor. 0 there. Let's go to ground to L2 or L1. Nothing, nothing. And nothing's going on there. So I've just electrically made this safe to work on. I can now cut my line set, disconnect my whip, and get my condensing unit out of here. I'm a huge fan of working smarter, not harder. Why should I get on my hands and knees disconnecting the whip from the unit when I could just unscrew two screws and then this whip is much more accessible to me. Look at that. Now, we are completely disconnected. That 13 after 8 here in the morning. She's gone. Manhandled that beast. Beautiful. Sweet. This is gonna look awesome, by the way. It's almost 9:45. I've been putzing around for the last hour and a half. Seriously, I got this up here by myself with the hand truck. There it is. Got a little creative getting it up here. We're working on a renovation. Once the new second floor right wing is framed out. We're going to be adding a 3-ton Mikey Pipes by ACIQ system. We're going to mount it to the wall right there, directly above this 4-ton. In the meantime, I cut back the 7/8 and I deburred the pipe. I deburred the pipe. I cleaned that with a piece of scratchy paper, emery paper. There's my 7/8 by 3/4 ZoomLock reducing coupling. The connections on the 3, 4, and 5-ton systems are all 3/4 on our suction side. Actually, they're all 3/4, should I say, on their ducted systems. I took off the 3/4-inch flare nut. I got a piece of 3/8. We're gonna flare this end of the pipe with the NAVAC automatic flaring tool. I'm gonna make a bend, another bend, and hopefully get this in there. I actually think I'm gonna make some bends first. Yeah, let's do that first. Let's get this in position. Let me press that in and let's make some bends into measurements and get this thing lined up. Put this bad boy in there. That goes in there like that. Now, I'm gonna need to put a turn, a bend. Let's put a bend right there. And that'll swoop into our connection there. So let me bend this and then take a measurement and cut. I should get the NAVAC automatic bending tool too, because I can't do this one-handed. Now, I'm gonna keep it real. One of my weaknesses is using the bender, and the other weakness is reversing valves and heat pumps and stuff like that. So, I hope, he who hopes dies in despair, right? I hope that this works out all right for me. We're gonna see. Let's take the 3/4. And by the way, the NAVAC only goes up to 3/4, which is a little bit of a disappointment. Oh, hold on. Folks, I gotta deburr the pipe. There you go. See that? I deburred the pipe. And while I'm at it, why are you gonna catch me for not doing it? Let's do the other side too. Now I deburred both ends. Now the YouTube police aren't gonna chase me down. And the folks over at ACIQ, they're still gonna like me for not messing up an install. Okay, right there. Lock into place. Push the button. Let it do its thing. Oh yeah, mama. Now, some of you may be asking, Mikey Pipes, why aren't you elevating this thing off of the platform? Homeowner doesn't want it on the wall. Doesn't want to go too high. And it very rarely will be used, if at ever, will be used for a heat pump. Just food for thought. Now, where's my scratchy paper? Oh. Under the phone. So I am going to clean this end. Okay. And now we're going to see if my bend is good. Got a little mark there for my depth insertion. You ready? Let me show you. That's already pressed in. There's our, right there. Okay. And we're a little short. All right, Let me push over the unit a little bit, line that up, bend that down, and get that flare nut on. It's okay. All right, after a few solid attempts to get this in there, and I mean a few, there's the scrap twice, and there's another piece there, but I just need to work on my brazing. I didn't have any wet rag. I used an actual wet rag and did my best there. My liquid and suction lines are connected now. We're going to work on the electric next and the low voltage communication wire from the indoor unit to the outdoor unit. I cleaned up some residual line set from an old mini split that was hanging out there. Just cleaning up a little bit. I'm going to throw a level on this when I'm done, and we'll bolt this to the cement slab here. But so far, 20 minutes to 11, not too shabby. All right, I am wiring up the communication wire, our 252, whatever it is. It's two-wire communication wire. It goes on those two terminals right there. One is on the right, two is on the left. They do claim it's non-polarity, but stick with the colors. Trust me, been there, done that. A little tech tip when hooking up your whip to the L1, L2, and ground connections. Remove the screw completely, put your wire in there, and then take the screw to your screwdriver. It's magnetic, and just guide that on there. Just how I did those two right there. Little tech tip, don't fight with it. Don't try to give it a haircut. Just take the screw out on the terminal completely, and then put the wire in, lay it right there. It's not going anywhere, and put your screw in. Easy peasy. All right, a few minutes after 12 here. We are pressurized with some nitrogen. My tank is kind of empty, but I have 149.5 PSI. I pulled my Schrader cores on both my suction and my liquid lines. Daniel pulled off the automatic expansion valve, sorry, the electronic expansion valve, and used a magnet to free open that piston inside the metering device. So we have pressure on our liquid side from... Actually, we have pressure on our suction side from the liquid up and around. So we're gonna let this sit for a hot minute, make sure we don't drop. That confirms our line set is good. Now this zone, one, two, three, four, five, six in this house has never needed to add a refrigerant before, so I don't think there'll be a problem with the line set, so make sure that our connections are good. What's great about the private label systems by ACIQ, you don't need to braze anything. Yes, I braze there because I have an existing line set, but there's flare connections on the outdoor unit and the indoor unit. All you need to have is the 3/8 and your 3/4 inch flaring block, and you are good. It's awesome. I absolutely love it. I've been waiting a very, very long time to have not being able to bring out the brazing rig. Yeah, we still need to do it here, but I love ACIQ, and the fact that it's communicating indoor to outdoor and also to thermostat. And if I want to use a regular thermostat, I could do that. If I want to use their awesome Wi-Fi thermostat, it's cheap, guys. If you're an HVAC contractor or a dealer, you want to start branding yourself, ACIQ is for you at a very, very, very reasonable price. And if you compare this against the Carrier Infinity, we're talking a significant major price discount between the two pieces of equipment. And guess what? This brand is made by Madea, which is ICP, which is same as Carrier, same as Bosch, same as all the other ones. Made in the same giant freaking plant the size of New York State in China. Come on. Listen, if it was made in the U.S., I would be supporting that as well. But it's a great product at a great price. Give your customers, your end users, the clients value with an awesome communicating system that also gives heat pump technology at the same time. It's awesome.
All right, a few minutes to one here. System is running. It's misting a lot, so I'm not going to put any stickers on it. When we come back here on Thursday for another replacement system, we'll put our branding stickers on it and make note of everything else that needs to be done here, which is nothing. The contractor is going to take care of the relocation of both disconnects when they pull down the siding, when they do upstairs. Other than that, looks epic, and it's whisper quiet. We are running at 100% whisper quiet. Absolutely love it. I think my bends are getting better. Let me get your thoughts and feedback in the comment section down below. So stick around in a couple days. We are going to be back here where we previously installed two Bosch 3-tons. We're going to take out this 3-ton Rheem system and put in another Mikey Pipes by ACIQ. Ultra high efficient communicating heat pump system. It's going to be perfect. They're not going to match, but we're going to make it look epic. So stick around, smash that thumbs up button, hit that notification bell to get post notifications when I drop a video. Catch you in the next one. Be well, God bless, stay safe. And remember, ladies and gentlemen, get your Mikey Pipes. If you ain't testing, you're guessing. Version 2.0. This was commissioned and manufactured in the longest running printing press in America at Hatch Show Print, a nonprofit organization that's inside the Country Music Hall of Fame in Nashville, Tennessee. The version 1.0 sold out in less than a week. Everyone is individually numbered and autographed. And if you want to personalize to someone's attention, I got you. $42.50 mailed to you anywhere in the United States. You're going to get five Mikey Pipe stickers, all unique stickers. You're going to get a pen. You're going to get a magnet. You're going to get my business card. I'm going to put it all in a nice little mailing tube anywhere in the United States. You got to love it. And then you can frame it like this. Look at this. You can do it with a border around it. You can do it without a border around it. Or like that. Very nice. What are you waiting for? $42.50. You can only get it from me on Zelle, Venmo, Cash App, PayPal, or send me your gold bullion, your bearer bonds, your coins, whatever you want in the mail. I got you. Catch you in the next one. Be well. God bless. Stay safe. And by the way, if you notice, he still had the scruff on his face. You can't fix stupid.